My name's Les. I'm from North Carolina in the States. And the way I ended up coming over here was basically, this would be my eighth major surgery in about 8 years. And I was having a battle with the insurance company, and I had fallen and knocked my replacement knee loose, and it needed to be replaced. And the insurance company, you know, wanted to replace just a part and not the whole thing. And I said, no, no, no. Enough, you know, major surgeries is enough, coupled along with four minor ones also. I was looking for alternative surgeries. And so I spent about 10 weeks looking at different things, some research, some were experimental. And when I came down to it, I finally eliminated the things in, say, Central America, some of the Philippines and other places in the world. I came down to Bangkok, Singapore, and India. And then I started really digging deep. And when I came down to the point of looking at the infection rate and success rate and look what was going on, it was pretty much hands down for India. The success rate was in the 99 percentile. And the infection rate, less than 1%. I couldn't find that anywhere else in the world. The amazing thing was that the prosthetic that needed to replace my replacement, called a revision, is made in the United States, but the FDA wouldn't allow it at the time. A few months ago, they finally approved it to be done there. And I started looking around, and so I finally decided, and I came on over. And I haven't been disappointed at all. I've been in the hospital a number of times. It makes me sort of a semi-expert on some of the things that go on. But here's a cultural thing. The care is not a job. It seems to come, the compassion and the empathy just comes out of the nursing staff. They have a good attitude. Place is clean. It seems like there's a whole systemic process that goes on that keeps the infection rate down. The infection rate is very important to me. I've had friends that have gotten the staph infection and really almost died from it. I've had one knee that did get infected one time, and it's no fun. So that was a key thing with me. And then when I started looking around, I saw it was, you know, something to do with Harvard International. I thought, well, you know, back in my family history, a couple of my ancestors that had money went to Harvard. Other challenges that have come about being away from home as long as that have been taken care of, which other hospitals wouldn't even deal with. And it's something you got to experience, and if no one has, they need to. They encourage you to bring a companion or family member with you, and that's not something else you have that you get anywhere else. When I go back to the States, my friends that are doctors and in the medical field and the dental field, I'm going to have a little, you know, I think our relationship will probably change, regrettably, but I think I've gotten better care here. I need, because of the knees, I had a couple of bad teeth that were going to have to be capped to make sure in the future we didn't have infections. At one point, they wanted to cap four teeth. Just offhanded, I ask about this. I can get 24 teeth capped for $100 more than four teeth in the States. Figures, I think, speak for themselves. My experience has been nothing but pleasant. The outlook has been great. The bedside manners has been beyond expectation. And the medical care I've got is just tremendous. I feel like I'm really cared for, and they really do care about how my outcome is.